Welcome to another episode of GeekOutdoors.com. So Blood Red Sky is a Netflix original German slash English film that is about an airplane hijacking and vampires. Yeah, that is something I don't hear very often, and it's probably the first time I've ever seen a movie like that. And it's generally about these three main characters. We have Nadja, who is a mother, her son Elias, and this guy named Farid. And so those are the main characters. There's many other characters, supporting characters as well, but those are the main ones we focus on. And that is like the general plot. There is people in this airplane. It gets hijacked by a terrorist slash group, and there is vampires. And so that's pretty much all you need to know. Now, getting into the things that I really enjoyed about this film is the story. This is so unique. I've never seen a story done like this before. And just that whole premise of vampires and airplane hijacking doesn't seem like it would be great, but it really is. Not only is it different, but the way in which the story is told, it's very focused, you know, very claustrophobic. And so it gives a lot of time to focus on the characters, the story, and what's going on. And so there's a lot of moments of tension that are built up. And at the same time, since it is so enclosed, you get to really feel more for the characters, you know, which leads me to the second thing, are the actual characters themselves. I really enjoy the central characters of the mom, Nadja, and her son, Elias, and some of their backstory. Now, Farid comes in later, and although he doesn't really have much to do per se, he does serve an important role in the whole story. And you see, as the story unfolds, there's a lot of things that make sense once you see it in terms of like why these characters were there and why they're there later. And so I really enjoyed the characters and the overall acting. I think it was really solid, you know. Specifically, I would say Nadja and Elias, they did a really great job. And I felt a lot of that emotion between them, which is another thing I enjoyed. This movie isn't really about vampires and the horror element. It's not really what that's about. It's more of a relationship type story. And it's something that's very different because it takes a more like realistic approach, you know, like what if you were to find out that somebody you knew and love is a vampire? And it's not the typical vampire, they're super powerful and they're doing all this, you know, superhero or villain type stuff. It's like normal people who are vampires, and how do they deal with that? And I really, really enjoyed that aspect. And so there's a lot of emotion involved with the acting and the story. So all of those things really help serve the entire story. And then I would say the final thing that I enjoyed about it is the overall pacing itself. This is like a 2-hour movie, but to me, it never really felt boring. It didn't feel like it's a 2-hour movie. And because of all those elements I described earlier, I was always interested, and really my attention was focused on the movie and the characters.
For serious YouTubers, check out TubeBuddy, the premier tool news at geekoutdoors.com. Get more done today by checking out the affiliate link in the description area below.
Now, getting to the things that I didn't like as much about this movie, even though I really enjoyed the story, the characters, and everything that was involved around that, you really don't know much about these characters. Now, they do definitely give some backstory and flashbacks of Nadja and Elias, so that really helps you understand how this whole vampire thing came about. But other than that, you really don't know much else. And all the other characters, you definitely don't know much else. And I'm pretty sure this was done intentionally because they really want to focus on the story and everything that's going on within this plane. And then the other thing that I didn't like quite as much is the fact that since it was so focused on that, this whole airplane hijacking, which is really what it's about, then you don't know much about the whole vampire world. You know, you could obviously tell that there's definitely another world out there, but you really don't know much about it, and the story itself doesn't focus too much time on that. And I really think that it was done intentionally. It makes sense. They really want to keep it enclosed in this main story of this airplane hijacking, which happens to involve vampires. But other than that, I really did enjoy this film. It's one of the few, I would say, horror genre type films that try to do something different, and overall, I think they succeeded. And just the way that the movie left off, I could easily see this growing into maybe another movie or maybe something else within this world. And I would definitely be back for that if they ever did that. So if you actually had any thoughts on this or any other movies that you've seen within this genre, be sure to leave down in the comments area below. And if you want to see more of my sci-fi or, you know, fantasy film reviews, I do have an entire playlist. I'll leave down in the description area as well. So as always, if you did get value out of these videos, be sure to share, like, and subscribe.
And if you're a creative geek like me, and you want to get exclusive access to more content that I don't put out here publicly on my YouTube channel, then join my Gold Content Creators Group, where you're going to get content like this and more for all the creative geeks out there. And the best part is, all of this is free. Simply head over to the link below, check out my page, and sign up for my Gold Content Creators Group.